Bun got acquired by Anthropic, and for me, that immediately brought up two important questions. One, what does that mean for me as a heavy user of Bun, because I use it for most of my projects? And the second question, of course, why? What's Anthropic getting out of that? What does it mean for Claude Code and so on? So let's take a look. And we got two articles, two statements, one by Anthropic, one by Bun. I read them, and of course, as we do it nowadays, I discussed them with AI. And I then used my site, Build My Graphic, to convert my summary, my results here, into a nice little infographic. And I want to start by taking a look at Bun's perspective. So Bun, obviously, is pretty popular. And as I mentioned, I'm using it for pretty much all of my projects. And just to be clear, by the way, this video is not sponsored by Bun or Anthropic. I just genuinely like working with Bun and also with Claude Code. I'm paying for everything there for Claude Code. Of course, Bun is free. And Bun is getting downloaded a lot, is growing a lot, has lots of GitHub stars, and collected some money, some funding, but, and that's the problem for them, has zero revenue. So clearly, the clock was ticking, kind of. And they make that very clear in their statements. In the Bun statement, they mentioned that they had over 4 years of runway to figure out monetization, and that they're growing a lot, but that they're not making any money. So clearly that's a problem, also because those investors typically want to get their money back. Now, they wrote, the Bun team wrote in their post that they eventually wanted to build a cloud hosting product to earn money, because that is, of course, the typical path for many open source projects. I mean, Dino has Dino Deploy, which in the end is a hosting product. Laravel, for example, has their own hosting products. It makes a lot of sense if you're building some open source technology. Now, they also mentioned that the world changed and that AI coding tools are this massive change to how developers do productive work, but that's now where Anthropic comes in. Anthropic, obviously, one of the main players in the AI world, besides OpenAI and Google and XAI and so on. And of course, Anthropic, mostly known amongst developers, I guess, for their Claude models and their Claude Code tool, which kind of uses these models with agentic capabilities to help you with coding. Now, Claude Code is super successful. They have a $1 billion run rate as of November 2025. So they're making $1 billion in revenue subscriptions with their Claude Code offering. And they do that 6 months after they launched Claude Code. So pretty popular. And I don't know about you, but for me, indeed, Anthropic and the Claude models, they are all about coding, right? So I'm using ChatGPT or the Gemini models for my research, my discussions, my summaries, you know what. And I know the Claude models could probably also do that, but for me, the Claude models are about coding, and Claude Code is amazing. I'm using it in conjunction with Cursor. Yes, I'm paying for both, and I'm not the only one. They got a bunch of popular companies using it too, and they rely on Bun for that, because Claude Code since October ships as a Bun single file executable, because that's one thing you can do with Bun. It can do many things, but one thing it can do is you can write some JavaScript or TypeScript code, JavaScript or TypeScript script or program, and you can then run a command with the Bun tool, with the Bun runtime, to kind of compile that into an executable, which you can then run without Bun installed on your system and without Node.js installed. So you can build it for different platforms, for Windows, Linux, macOS, and you can then share that with other people. And that, of course, is what Claude Code is. And the advantage of this approach is, of course, that Claude Code can be installed by everybody, not just by people that have Node.js installed on their system. And then you have the problem that people might have the wrong version of Node.js, and it's not fun. So that's why they switched, why Anthropic switched to this single file solution using Bun for Claude Code. So clearly they rely on Bun, and clearly they don't want Bun to run out of money, because they want it to become a stale project, not be maintained anymore. That would be an issue for them. So that is probably one of the reasons why they acquired Bun, to kind of save it, so give it that lifeline in the end, which is one of the reasons, I guess, why they bought it. And of course, also there's a lot of talent to be gathered from the Bun team, I'm sure of that. Now, it's one of the reasons, but not the only reason, I guess. They, Anthropic, in their post also mention the performance of Bun as another important reason, that Bun is redefining speed and performance for modern software engineering, and that Bun has improved JavaScript and TypeScript by optimizing for reliability, speed, and delight. And yes, this is all true. That's one of the reasons why I'm using Bun for many projects. By the way, the other reason, or one of the other reasons, is that Bun has many built-in very useful features, like a built-in SQLite driver, so that you don't need an extra package for working with SQLite, or a built-in S3 client, which also happens to be faster than the official AWS SDK JavaScript S3 client. So I'm using these features too when working with Bun. And that is all true, and these are all good reasons to use Bun, but let's be honest, what is the slow part about Claude Code or any of these agentic tools? It's not really the time JavaScript needs to do something. It's the time it takes for the model to generate its response, to generate its tool call instructions, and so on. And that's not getting sped up by Bun, obviously. So yeah, speed probably matters, but it's not the most important argument, I would argue. Now, obviously, it can help if those AI agents are faster. That can all be useful, but it's probably not the main reason. One important reason, I would imagine, however, is the control aspect. If Anthropic controls Bun, which they now do, they can, of course, kind of control which features make it into Bun, what it's optimized for. And, for example, they can prioritize stuff like VASM support, that they can build sandboxes or sandbox features into Claude Code that allow Claude Code to generate code which it can then execute itself in a secure sandbox, for example, using Bun again for that. Because of course, Anthropic, with the success they have with Claude Code, want to make that more versatile, more powerful, want to give it more features. And giving agents more tools, tools to write and execute code in secure sandboxes, is one important building block in that vision, I would imagine. And that is where, of course, they, Anthropic, want to be able to control which features make it into Bun and how well it supports executing different programming languages inside of such a sandbox and spinning up sandboxes and everything related to that. And that's also what you can find, for example, on Reddit. Many people there share this exact opinion that it's mostly about this control aspect. And of course, about the fact that you don't want Bun to disappear because they run out of money. Now, the big question, of course, therefore, is what does this mean for us as developers using Bun if it becomes Anthropic's Bun, which is optimized for Anthropic? Now, Bun itself, in their statement at the very beginning, they write that it will stay open source and MIT licensed, and that their roadmap will continue to focus on high-performance JavaScript tooling, Node.js compatibility, and replacing Node.js as the default server-side runtime. And especially the compatibility part is important, because Bun is amazing, but one of the main selling points of Bun is that in many, not all, but in many projects, you can use it as a drop-in replacement for Node.js because it is compatible. It's not fully compatible yet. There still are some areas where they need to catch up. And of course, it's also not just about being compatible with the past features, but also with new features, new capabilities added to Node.js. And they clearly commit to this here. And I'm confident that they will really do that, because they probably also know, Anthropic probably knows, that if they let Bun just die, it's not going to make them more popular. And of course, for all their sandboxing and so on stuff, they also rely on Bun being able to execute Node.js code and therefore have that compatibility. But we'll see if that really is the case, but I'm very confident that it will turn out that way. Because obviously that is important to me. I'm using Bun, I want to keep on using it. And for that, I need to be confident that it will be actively developed, that it will not just be fine-tuned for Anthropic needs, but that instead they will continuously come up with amazing features like that built-in S3 client, and that they will stay Node.js compatible and become even more compatible. So yeah, that's that. That is that Bun acquisition by Anthropic. Pretty exciting. And I guess we'll see how Bun will continue to evolve over the next months and year, and which new features we can get out of Claude Code now with that close or deep Bun integration.